talk about when it's useful to be negative and when it's useful to be positive, because there is actual times when, you know, we want to be the most positive gym we can be, but that doesn't mean that we're just going to like close our eyes and tap our heels together three times and hope all our lifts go overhead and all our burpees are perfect standard and our runs are always PBs. There is actually a time for when we can be quote unquote negative. Now, what we don't mean by that is disastering. That doesn't mean waiting until the open and going, I really hope chest bars don't come up, because guess what, they're coming up, you know? Or I'm not good at heavy deadlifts, so I really hope they don't come up when they come up. It's a disaster and my open's ruined and all that. Or indeed, if you look at weightlifting competitions, what happens if your openers don't go too well? Or what happens if the gym is out of fractional plates? Or what happens if you don't have stretch bands or they get rid of the 10-minute break? Do you know, how do you plan for these things, okay? First of all, you look at what could go wrong, and more importantly, what could go wrong that I could deal with, okay? And this is where if-then statements come into plan, into effect. So if we're planning, say, we'll use weightlifting, okay? If there is no fractionals in the warm-up room, then I have a different warm-up build-up. I will hit doubles at 25 and doubles at 30 instead of going 27, 29, 31, okay? And that gives you something that when it happens, when disaster happens and fractionals go missing,
Time cap.
The fractionals go missing, okay? Or if I can't hold pace of 10 burpees a minute in the workout, okay, then I'll stop for 15 seconds, take 5 big deep breaths, and then I'll do 5s and take a break every 5, okay? If I can't do my toes to bar in 2 sets in the workout, then I will go to 3 sets. Right? And you just create an if-then statement for anything that could go wrong that's within your control before the workout begins. Okay? And these if-then statements can be applied to any goal you have. Okay? If I'm on a weight loss kick, if they bring in cake in the office, I'll move to a different seat. Okay? I'll take up my apple and I'll eat it first. Okay?
That ain't happening.
Not if they bring in cake in the office, I'll go, well, fine, I've got to live. YOLO. And then you notice that, well, my weight loss goal isn't happening because, well, my mates had that takeaway and I couldn't say no. And they were going out for the beer for the Tunisia-Senegal game that I've never watched before in my life, but I have to go to it. Okay? If I'm going out, then I'll eat my meal at home first so I'm not tempted to join in for the dirty curry chips. And you can use this if-then statement. So for anything happens. Now, when is it important to be positive? It's positive important in the moment, okay? We see a tough workout come up in the open. Everybody's gonna do this. This is my chance to get my first chest to bar, or my first toes to bar. This is my chance to PR my deadlift or my power snatch or get finally ring muscles, okay? In the moment, Jason Kalipa has this expression we think is brilliant. It's like, how would you coach your best friend, okay? In the moment you come off the wall and you're trying to do unbroken handstand push-ups, you come off the wall, you would not go, you are a fucking idiot. What the fuck is wrong with you? You would not say that to your best friend, we hope. All right? You would say, it's okay, breathe, take a couple of seconds, let's kick back up, let's do 2s. Okay? You'd be positive and you'd coach yourself and encourage yourself through it as well. Okay? So when you're planning for whatever goal you have, look at what could go wrong and what you do when it invariably happens, and that's your negative thinking. Alright, and then from then on, you can be positive knowing that you've planned to prepare yourself for the best. Alright, thanks Steve.
Thank you.